risk management with different backgrounds focuses on long-term profitability. Last quarter, we performed financially 5 times better than our closest competitor, and with just three products in three stores in US, Europe, and China, we have had the highest sales. We target at Travis and Innovators, and are targeting Mercedes and Workhorse as well. Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today we will be presenting on our business. We will be covering company background, competitive advantage, setbacks faced, strategies, and financials. Our CEO is Sonali, and we have Howard, Eugene, Rohan, and Jabel. I'm Annabelle. Okay, in Novo, we plan to surpass expectations using these products. We are launching one new product in Workhorse. We have 2 in Travelers and 2 in Innovators. This is our company overview. As you can see, we are the leading company, and we top everyone in terms of performance, financial performance, marketing effectiveness, and wealth. And we are the 3rd lowest financial risk. Sales offices. We have open sales offices in New York, London, and Guangzhou, and Atlanta and Berlin. And we plan to open some more, another 3 more in this quarter. In terms of competitive advantage, as you can see, we are the winner in every industry in terms of profitability, market growth, and market appeal. We rank as the number one, as the only winner in terms of profitability and market appeal for every single product of ours. Okay. Again, I reinforce my point that we are very high in profitability as compared to all the other companies. Setbacks. I'll now pass on the setbacks to Sonali. Thank you.
Thank you, Annabelle. As we reinstated that we have higher profitability, but like every other company, we do face certain setbacks. Our setbacks were that we were unable to achieve the highest market leader in the three target segments that we were selling our products in. We were selling our products in Innovators, Mercedes, and Travelers. However, we were only the second behind QM Holdings, which was the market leader. The second setback that we faced was we had approximately 49% left over inventory in quarter 3 and 30% left over in quarter 4. This could have been an excess inventory and could have posed some challenges to us. However, we did come up with strategies to overcome our setbacks. Before I go on to explain about our strategies, I'd quickly like to give an overview of our competitors. QM Holdings and New Magic, which are our very neck-to-neck competitors, faced a heavy stockout in the previous quarter. Their demand will be probably reduced by 33.5% and 3.3%. At the same time, Micro Inc. also had a lesser demand because they had no new products to offer last quarter. So leveraging on this fact of their lower demand and our increased demand, we plan to fight back to become not only the overall leader, but also the market leader. Then I'd go on to the strategy about our company. In quarter 5, we plan to gain market share, like I just said. We plan to invest in R&D, upgrade our products, and create advertisements to capture market share in all of the markets that we operate in. Secondly, we plan to increase production. 5 out of 8 competitors are experiencing stockouts right now, and we have a high capability of producing stocks, and we are going to expand further. Third, we're going to try projecting a more accurate demand in order to control our inventory and balance it with the stocks that we produce and sell. Our strategies in the further quarters in 6 to 8 would be use further invest in R&D, better our products, target new segment products, actually go into every segment possible, then expand globally, get control of all the markets available. Create and maintain market share. It is very important for us to be the leaders in everything. We believe in achieving the highest in everything that we do. And at the same time, we also believe in maintaining a fair share with our competitors. So we plan to create collaborations in licensing R&D to make our products better and their products better as well. I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Finally, I'd like to go through the financials of our company. Our entry valuation actually makes our company present entry valuation at $11 million. The amount that we ask from you is $5 million, in which we would offer you 30% of our company, which translates to 17 600 shares of our company. Also, the average ROI is 142% of our company. That means every quarter that we score is 142% share gained by the investor. Also, our earnings per share sum up to 274 per share. Lastly, the exit valuation of our company comes up to $143 million. And the amount the investor receives is actually 751% more than what he invests. The gain made per dollar is $9 per dollar invested. What are we going to do with this $5 million that you invest in us? We will invest in R&D to improve the quality of our products. We will expand sales offices. And we will also invest in the production capacity of our company. We would like to conclude our business plan presentation with this. And we welcome questions from you guys.
You mentioned that you have stockouts, right? Why?
We
all identify the...
No, not stockouts. They have excess
inventory. Yeah, excess. Do you identify what? Why did you?
For the first quarter, we actually had 49%, which was, I think, it was a miscalculation on our part. We actually forecasted a lot, and we produced a lot.
So this is quarter two.
This was in quarter
two.
Three.
Quarter three. And how did you get rid of this excess inventory?
We sold it to China. And we introduced new products. Basically, we had sales offices in China. We had sales offices in the US and Europe as well. So China was basically the place where we were selling off our old inventory at slash prices.
So did you get rid of it?
Mostly, yes. And our demand, our demand forecasting is growing better. So next time, we only have 30% excess, which we plan to sell off this
Have you
quarter.
Guys broke even yet?
We only ran losses in the quarter two. From quarter three onwards, we made $1 million profit every quarter. Currently, our profit is 4.9 million, I think. Yeah.
And what's the value per share?
Value per share will be 279, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, you could check in the financials that we produced.
Okay.
It'll be more exact.
Okay.
Maybe two questions to somebody that hasn't spoken yet.
Yeah, sure.
What is your future for your R&D investor? Which target segment are you going into? Because you have only three sectors, right? Which one will you focus on?
For R&D, right, since we are in terms and financially stable at the current moment and expecting a decent, expecting the investment from on your part, we aim to score at the highest R&Ds available, the ones which target a large number of groups. For example, we see that there is one R&D which is at 2.9 million, which is ease of use, which according to our market research shows that it applies to a wide variety of groups. It targets innovator, it targets Mercedes, and it also targets workhorse. So R&D like this could be very valuable for our products because they would help all our products across all our target segments. But of course, we would give priority to our innovator product and our traveler product.
So you guys are not going to go into cost cutters or workhorse?
We currently have only one product in workhorse. We are planning not to go into cost cutters before going into Mercedes. Our next quarter will focus us going into Mercedes first.
Because you will have the R&D for
because
that?
Yes. And because we assume high profitability and high demand in Mercedes as well.
And the number of sales offices?
We have